All right. Good morning, Mr. Attorney. Can you give me your name and your date of birth, sir?
Michael R. Attorney, 219-48.
All right. And the state you want to announce?
George Kellerman from the Maricopa County Attorney's Office. Good morning, Your Honor.
Good morning. And the defense?
Good morning, Judge. Ashley Otto and Jamie Jackson on behalf of Michael Attorney.
All right. All right, so let's go ahead and go forward with this matter. All right, Mr. Attorney, you are here in response to a Superior Court grand jury warrant. The charge is as follows. It is one count, murder in the second degree, a class one felony, allegedly occurring in May 17, 2001. Mr. Jackson and Ms. Otto are here from the Public Defender's Office representing you throughout this process. Mr. Kellerman's here from the state. Right now, you have some upcoming court dates happening, but before I get into the court dates, I know that there's a question of bond, so I would like to hear from both sides of the aisle here. Mr. Kellerman, did you want to be heard on release conditions?
Yes, Your Honor. There was a grand jury warrant that was issued yesterday in the amount of $500,000 secured a court bond. Now, the state would request that bond be affirmed on the warrant.
All right, and the defense?
Thank you, Judge. Mr. Attorney is a 72-year-old disabled veteran. He was born and raised in Arizona. He has a stable place to live. Mr. Attorney suffers from a myriad of physical health issues. He requires a CPAP machine to sleep. He has blood pressure issues, heart and lung issues, blood clots in his legs. All of his service providers are here in Arizona. He receives services at the VA as well as federal workman's comp. His physical health issues aside, I want to touch briefly on the evidence in this case or lack thereof. And while I can't speak to all of the evidence, this case is 20 years old. There is no confession, no body, no crime scene, no DNA. Mr. Attorney has remained cooperative since the beginning of this case, and he has every intention to do so. He has maintained his innocence since 2000, and his intention is to see that through in court. With that being said, also, he has no failures to appear. He is willing to abide by any terms of release the court deems appropriate. Defense at this time is asking for a $25,000 to $35,000 secured appearance bond with electronic monitoring and house arrest.
I appreciate that. Anything else from the defense?
Nothing else, thank you.
Okay, all right. State, any response to the defense's argument?
The state's response is, Your Honor, that this is a homicide case, whether it occurred yesterday or 20 years ago. In terms of probable cause, that's already been determined by a grand jury. It's not being determined by the CIA court. And the state would request that since a judicial officer at the return of the true bill, the indictment in this case, has already determined that a $500,000 secured appearance bond in a homicide case is appropriate, the state would request that this court simply affirm that. And if defense counsel, for the reasons that she's recited to this court, believes that those are appropriate to modify the release terms on the warrant, they can certainly file a motion for modification of release terms, where all of those arguments can be duly made. State has no doubt that defense counsel is representing to the best of their knowledge the situation, but at this point, the state would believe they've in no way been able to confirm his medical conditions, everything that they know they've learned through him. So, I apologize for the lengthy request, but the state believes that there should be no modification in tonight's IA release terms on a grand jury bond that was issued less than 24 hours ago. Thank you.
All right, here's my decision. Mr. Attorney, I understand the age, 72 years old. I don't doubt for a second that your attorney's avowals of your health issues are evident. All right, so I am taking consideration your health issues. I am taking consideration the fact that you probably have been an upstanding citizen, not missed any court, you have ties to the community, you may not be a flight risk. But I cannot discount the information that's provided by the state. This was a grand jury indictment. It was reviewed by a grand jury. And again, he is correct. A judicial officer did make a decision, albeit 20 years ago, but it still was a decision that was made. Nothing has changed that in our eyes. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to affirm the $500 security appearance bond, $500,000 security appearance bond that was issued by the grand jury with, I don't believe that I added any additional, I only added pretrial services. I don't believe he needs to be monitored electronically. He is not to possess any weapons. And he does have, and Mr. Kellerman is absolutely right. With the information that you provided this court, you will have an opportunity to present that again at future hearings. Yes, you know, put a motion out there to modify release conditions at a subsequent hearing. So you do have that opportunity to do that. But I'm going to affirm the $500,000 security appearance bond that was imposed by the grand jury with pretrial services upon his release. I do need to let him know that he does have court for not guilty arraignment on August 28th, 2020, 8:30 a.m. That's going to be down the street on Madison Superior Court. Those are the conditions that I've just indicated. Aside from the bond and pretrial services, there are any other additional limitations if he is able to make that bond. Does everybody understand my decision today?
The state does, Your Honor. Thank you.
Yes, thank you, Judge.
You're welcome. All right, Mr. Attorney, those are your conditions. You're going to get paperwork that has all that information on it. So go ahead and step to the site and get that paperwork, and that's it for today, and good luck, sir.
Thank you.